This is a note to future me, dated podcast publishing date. I'm going to entitle this one Shiny Object Delusions. Going to be a little bit coded, but at the same time, I'll know what it references. For podcasters looking at different options for podcast player platforms. And I guess really the big talk is the excitement that Spotify, they're accepting podcasts, get my podcast in there. And of course, the platforms are allowing that with the back end, which is great. Blueberry, Spreaker, Libsyn kind of is the back door quicker into Spotify versus, you know, submission through a Google form. It's great. There are devil in the details in regards to being a part of Spotify, a part of Google Play, a part of even Anchor, which in itself is its own platform, and Google Play. And that's just to name the top three or four that's really being talked about right now. Know that when you submit your podcast to Spotify, to Google Play, to iHeart, that your audio is being cached. In other words, they grab that audio one time and that's it. You can't change the commercial inside it. That episode will play forever. Even if you made a mistake and you need to edit it down the road and you're hoping the RSS feed will change it in the player down the road, not on those platforms. A discussion just recently about Radio Public, where, yes, they have a monetization opportunity for podcasters, but when you submit your audio to them, number one, no advertising within it unless it is a live read or host read. And their monetization opportunity lies in how many plays your podcast gets within their platform. So they're encouraging and kind of forcing your hand as a podcaster to tell your listeners that you must play my podcast on the Radio Public app. Not many people are going to be changing their way just to listen to your podcast. Not when you have 65 to 70% of listenership coming from the iTunes, Apple Play area and other apps that they're used to. They're not going to change just for your podcast unless they started there. The big thing is, yes, these are all shiny objects and people hear about, oh, wow, Spotify, I want to get on there. Yes, you know, the music format, it's changed to podcast. That's great. Another platform that's easy. It's can be used on both iOS and Android. Great, but you better read the fine print. Take a look at what they do with your audio that you may not like. And ultimately, it still comes down to telling your podcast listeners to go to your website. That is the gold mine. They got to go to your website, and then the opportunities are there to listen to your podcast. You tell them the different ways to listen to the podcast. Totally up to them. And again, I don't downplay, I don't want those other platforms, those players, not to make money with what they're doing. It's great. It's just beware. The shiny free object is not necessarily the best place for you to be. It comes down to taking a look at your goals for your podcast. And if it fits what you want to do, that's great. You do it. And if not, avoid it like the plague. Or know what you're walking into and know that once it's in that system, it's there forever. Thanks for taking notes with me. This is a note to future me.